For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a high-end motherboard from MSI that is powered by the flagship AMD X870E chipset and is targeted at you folks out there who are intending to build a white-colored AMD AM5 PC, the MSI MPG X870E HTI Wi-Fi, sporting support for the latest Ryzen 9000 series of processors, as well as the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs, as well as the older Ryzen 7000 series of CPUs. We'll be taking a closer look at the specs of this board to see if it's any good. Let's get started. To recap, AMD launched its Zen 5 Ryzen 9000 series of processors back in August 2024, and the high-end X870E and X870 chipsets for the AM5 platform back in September 2024. Fast forward to January 2025, we now finally have AMD's mid-range and entry-level 800 series chipsets arriving on the scene in the form of the B850 and the B840. Alongside MSI's new motherboards featuring the B850 and B840 chipsets, MSI has also introduced a white-colored X870E motherboard, the MPG X870E HTI Wi-Fi that, as its name implies, sports the X870E chipset and sits within the MPG series of performance-oriented motherboard offerings at the higher end, where it places below MSI's flagship MEG series and above the MAG series that is targeted at the mainstream demographic. As can be seen, the MPG X870E HTI Wi-Fi comes in a rather colourful box with an image of the motherboard splashed across the front. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, let's have a look at the contents of the box. First up, we get a white-colored Wi-Fi antenna in this box right here. Let's set aside the board for now to see what else MSI has included with it. As can be seen, we've got a whole bunch of cables here, starting first with two SATA 3 cables. And these are accompanied by an EZ front panel cable that helps make hooking up the front panel connectors of your PC case to the motherboard a breeze. We do also get a special 1-to-3 EZ con cable, a new MSI specific feature that allows end users to connect an addressable RGB device, a fan, and a USB device to the EZ con header on the motherboard so as to simplify things. I'll cover EZ con in more detail later on in this video. We do also get an EZ M.2 clip 2 remover tool, a USB flash drive containing the motherboard's drivers and utilities, as well as a M.2 drive slot backplate screw. In terms of documentation, we get a regulatory information leaflet right here. And this is accompanied by a quick installation guide. We do also get a sheet of MSI stickers. And to round things off, a MSI survey leaflet. Onto the board itself, we see that MSI has gone for a silver and white color scheme with a white PCB, silver colored heatsinks, and black hardware connectors. If you watched the video where I covered the MSI MPG B850 HTI Wi-Fi previously, you'll be forgiven for thinking that you're seeing double, as both boards do indeed look very similar to each other. That aside, the rear of the motherboard is quite a standard affair, though we do get some markings that serve as a warning not to install unneeded motherboard standoffs within your PC case, which could otherwise damage the board. MSI has also taken the liberty to include protective paint around the motherboard's screw holes so as to protect the PCB against scratches, which is a nice touch. RGB junkies will be pleased to note that the board comes with built-in Mystic Light RGB LEDs that can be found on the cover of the integrated I/O shield, like so. The VRM heatsinks for this board are decently sized, and MSI has included 14 plus 2 plus 1 power stages with 80 amp power phases. The X870E chipset has a dual chipset design, and the said chips sit beneath this large passive heatsink right here. For M.2 drive cooling, MSI has provided full heatsink coverage for all four M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the MPG X870E HTI Wi-Fi comes with four DDR5 slots with a dual tab design that, as of the time of publishing this video, comes with support for up to 256GB of RAM and the DDR5 8400 standard when overclocked. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, along the long edge of the board is a USB 20GBPS Type-C front panel header that supports power delivery for up to 27 watts of power for fast charging. And further down, two USB 5GBPS Type-A front panel headers, with each header providing support for up to two USB 5GBPS Type-A ports, for a total of four ports. We do also get two USB 2.0 front panel headers along the bottom edge of the board, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports, for a total of four ports. Some interesting features to highlight: back at the top of the motherboard, we get a set of EZ debug LEDs and an EZ digi debug LED that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues. We also get an EZCon header right here. As mentioned earlier, EZCon is a new MSI-specific connector, and it allows end users to easily connect MSI's next-generation AIO CPU coolers to the motherboard with just one onboard connector. For end users who do not have such a MSI AIO cooler, the EZCon header can still be used with non-MSI devices via the included 1-3 EZCon cable, which, as can be seen, comes with an addressable RGB header, a 4-pin fan header, as well as a USB header. Moving on, near the primary PCIe 5.0x4 M.2 slot is a TPM header for an optional TPM module, and near the bottom edge of the motherboard, we get a chassis intrusion header. We do also get an 8-pin supplemental PCIe power connector that provides for an additional source of juice for the power-hungry flagship GPUs of tomorrow. According to MSI, the said connector can provide for up to 252 watts of supplemental power. Moving on, we have here an easy LED control switch that allows you to disable all of the board's onboard LEDs, a clear CMOS header, as well as a safe boot jumper right here that, when enabled, forces the system to boot with default BIOS settings and a lower PCIe link speed from the CPU. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0x16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot sports MSI's Steel Armor 2 design to reinforce the slot for use with heavy graphics cards. As can be seen, the slot also comes with the EZ PCIe Release feature that helps make removing a graphics card a painless affair. Pressing down on this button here will undo the latch for the installation or removal of a graphics card, and we even get a little window that shows whether the latch is locked in place or not. Pretty nifty. We do also get a full-length PCIe 3.0x16 slot that operates at X1 mode, as well as a full-length PCIe 4.0x16 slot that operates at X4 mode. Also, in case you're unaware, PCIe 5.0 is only supported when you have a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. It's worth noting that the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. If you do have a Ryzen 8000 APU installed on this board, depending on which model of APU you have, the primary PCIe 5.0x16 slot for a graphics card will operate at either PCIe 4.0x8 or X4 mode instead. In the storage department, MSI has included four SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration. For M.2 slots, it comes with two PCIe 5.0x4 M.2 slots and two PCIe 4.0x4 M.2 slots. Do note that all of these slots support NVMe SSDs only. M.2 SATA drives will not work in any of these slots. All of the board's M.2 heatsinks feature a toolless design called EZ M.2 Shield Froser 2, which makes removing and installing the heatsink really easy. All you've got to do is press down on the button located at the side of the heatsink and lift the heatsink away from the board. Reinstalling it is a cinch too. Simply slide it back into place and press down till you hear a click. Another quality of life feature that the M.2 slots have is EZ M.2 Clip 2, which is a spring-loaded standoff device that makes installing and removing a M.2 drive a toolless affair like so. If you're intending to install a M.2 drive in a length other than the standard 2280 form factor, you can use the included EZ M.2 Clip 2 remover tool to reposition the EZ M.2 Clip 2 device accordingly. Again, do bear in mind that PCIe 5.0 is only supported with a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. The Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. On the topic of M.2 slots being disabled, while this board's Gen 5 M.2 slots do not share bandwidth with the PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card, we're still unable to escape the fact that the USB 4 controller that is mandated by AMD for the X870E and X870 chipsets still require PCIe lanes from somewhere, and for the X870E HTI Wi-Fi, what MSI has done is to have the USB 4 ports share PCIe lanes with the second PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slot, where slot M2.2 will run at PCIe 5.0 X2 link speeds instead when the USB 4 ports are in use. I do appreciate the fact that end users have some form of configurability, where if you have no use for the USB 4 ports, you can disable them via the BIOS, and the second PCIe 5.0 M.2 slot will operate at its full X4 link speed instead. For audio, MSI has included a high-end Realtek ALC 4080 audio codec, while for wired internet connectivity, we get a Realtek RTL 8126 chip that provides support for 5 Gigabit Ethernet. Wi-Fi support is courtesy of a Qualcomm QCNCM 865 Wi-Fi 7 part that supports the 320MHz channel width and also serves up Bluetooth 5.4 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with a whopping 8 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 Gen 2 addressable RGB headers and a single 12V RGB header located in these regions. Moving over to the rear I/O, the MPG X870E HTI Wi-Fi goes for an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with a flash BIOS button that allows you to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM or graphics card, a clear CMOS button, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports a maximum output resolution of 8K at 60Hz, 5 USB 10Gbps Type-A ports. We do also get 2 USB 4 Type-C ports that support the DisplayPort 1.4 standard for a maximum display output resolution of 4K at 60Hz each. 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, a 5 Gigabit Ethernet port, a USB 10Gbps Type-C port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors with the new MSI EZ antenna connectors, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. In conclusion, the MSI MPG X870E HTI Wi-Fi is indeed a premium motherboard offering that is targeted at PC hardware enthusiasts who are looking to build a high-end AMD AM5 PC in white, where it definitely looks and feels the part. It's also great to note that unlike the earlier X870E boards that launched late last year, this X870E board actually does not have any of the lane sharing shenanigans that would result in the halving of the PCIe 5.0 X16 slot's bandwidth when you have a certain configuration of M.2 drives installed. In addition, this board sports a VRM setup that will handle high-end Ryzen 9000 processors with ease, PCIe 5.0 support for both a graphics card and two M.2 drives, 5 Gigabit Ethernet with built-in Wi-Fi 7, a nice array of USB Type-C and Type-A connectivity options, along with a whole bunch of quality of life features such as EZ PCIe Release, EZ M.2 Clip 2, and so on. It's worth noting though, that this board is very similar in terms of specs and aesthetics as compared to the MPG B850 HTI Wi-Fi that I covered previously. In addition, we're still unable to escape some form of PCIe lane sharing due to the presence of the USB 4 controller, where the said controller now shares lanes with the second PCIe 5.0 X4 slot instead of affecting the GPU, which I suppose is the lesser of two evils. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.